Hi, it's me Carllie and welcome you to my channel, where we will explore different ways of developing a good routine. Then let's continue on freezing ourselves up, which is kind of comforting nowadays considering the temperatures outside. Today, I will help you make up your mind about the Wim Hof method. We'll discover the behind the scenes of the Wim Hof method and check it how it influences our body. So what's about all this science? You've probably heard that the Wim Hof method benefits the immune system. Surely those benefits are positive. But what are they? To explain this, we need to remind ourselves few things. Immune system. What is it? It's a group of tissues, of cells, of the proteins or chemical compounds which cooperate together so we can stay healthy. All of this to protect us from bacteria, viruses, toxins or wounds. It even activates when we come across some allergens and when we work out our muscles. So how it works in this micro world? For example, when you cut your skin and some bacteria will enter your body, a cell, let's call it a granulocyte, will eat it. And when it does, it will immediately invite his pals over the dinner table. The invitation in this microworld is signalized by cytokines, which are small proteins like interleukin beta, interleukin 6 or tumor necrosis factor alpha. Weird words, but we have the shortcuts. Those pro-inflammatory cytokines also activate the vessels to make the way for the incoming pals, hungry pals. This is how the inflammation begins. And by inflammation, I mean the redness and the heat caused by the dilated vessels. Oedema, which is the escape of the liquids, the cells and other chemical compounds into the tissue from the vessel. Pain, because it all gets on our nerves and like literally. And if we don't stop this inflammation, it can end up with the organ failure. I know this is a lot, but please stay focused for just few more minutes. When the granulocyte digests the virus, it sends the signal about the virus's characteristic and we call it antigens to the other cell, the lymphocyte. This little guy is the main trouble solver or trouble maker, as we can see later. It is producing the antibodies which perfectly fit antigens of the digested virus. Now the organism has a perfectly designed army to chase the virus away. Also, the lymphocyte saved this recipe for the specially designed antibodies in their memory, so that the next time they will meet this virus, they don't need to waste time and attack the virus immediately. Then what are the autoimmune diseases like colitis ulcerosa or rheumatoid arthritis? Well, when the immunity cells are overstimulated, they can't tell if the cells that they come across are foreign or not. They just want to attack it and eat it. And all the mechanism repeats. The antigens of our own cells are sent to the lymphocyte and now he's producing the perfectly designed army against our own cells. And about that, lymphocytes save the recipe for this perfectly designed army in their memory. So yes, this is the moment when they become the troublemaker. It is not happening all the time, but there are some risk factors that actually facilitates this. And we can include their bad diet, toxins, environment, suspicious genes. Those genes are very suspicious and they often suspect ourselves to be the foreign one. And infections. Then where the Wim Hof method stands in all of this? Wim Hof method attenuates the whole inflammatory response. This doesn't mean that we are left defenseless. It means that even though we are constantly exposed to these risk factors, our immune system will not overreact. How is it possible? Breathing techniques is starting respiratory alkalosis by exhaling carbon dioxide by the hyperventilation phase, which helps you holding your breath after the exhalation. Breath holds cause hypoxia, which results in anaerobic respiration and producing lactates. During this breathing, the sympathetic nervous system is activated by adrenaline, which correlates with increased interleukin 10 levels. Now, what connects the interleukin 10 and the lactates? It's anti-inflammatory role. They both decrease the pro-inflammatory cytokines like interleukin 6 or tumor necrosis factor. So they stabilize the immunity system and protects it from overreacting, simply speaking. Then where is the role of ice bathing or the cold showers? Well, that's not that deeply known yet. The hypotheses are that they activate the survival genes. Those genes are helping us to survive and stay healthy. Like in this paper, a routine hot to cold shower resulted in reduction of the self-reported sickness and absence in work. But if you accidentally do get sick, the illness lasts as many days as if you were not taking cold showers at all. And the last but not least, the depression. It is said that the depression may be caused by our easy lifestyle, as one of many factors. Well, compared to the ancient history. And by taking the cold showers, we remind ourselves this urge to survive. And believe me, there may not be many papers on that, but ice baths bring this joy and this will for the survive into our lives. Ask anybody who tried. I bet they feel more happy and awakened after the cold shower. All of this, of course, is the perfect prophylaxis and in addition to the main therapy. This was a lot this time, wasn't it? Now share this video to your friends and maybe you will find some Wim Hof-like buddy to make the cold shower with you. You know, the cold showers, not in the one shower, or maybe in the one shower as you like to, who knows? And please subscribe to my channel if you want to continue this good routine journey with me. And if you find this video useful, you can give me a thumbs up. Ciao!